out here a little bit earlier today and checked on the church, make sure the roof wasn't. It wasn't, so I thank God for that. Amen. Hallelujah. We just appreciate each and every one that's come out and be with us. Our church folks, some of them's not here tonight, so we'll pray for them. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We got some out sick. But we just need to pray for them tonight. We're going to go before the Lord in prayer tonight. But let's give our visitors a big hand tonight. Amen. I'm glad to see Sister Ann and them, their church here with us tonight. Sister Amy and
Lisa, Deborah,
and John. And John. We're glad to see them. They're from North Carolina. Praise the Lord. We're just glad everybody's here tonight. We're going to go before the Lord in prayer tonight. We're going to ask God just to come in and have his way in the church. If you don't care, just stand. And we'll just ask God to come in tonight. Blessed Heavenly Father, Lord God, as we come to you, Lord God, we thank you, God, for this opportunity, God, to be in the house of the Lord. God, to be able to lift you up tonight, God, and to give you honor and to give you praise, God. And Lord God, we just want to thank you, Lord God, for this service tonight, God, for what you're going to do tonight. God, we just want to thank you, Lord God, for our young people, Lord God. We pray, God, you use them tonight, God, in a mighty way, God. Anoint them tonight, God. Anoint this service tonight, God. We ask you right now, God. Lord God, I pray that you anoint Brother Red tonight as he brings the word for it, God. I pray, God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, we give you the praise. God, we give you the glory tonight. God, you're worthy to be praised tonight. And God, we thank you for it, God. We ask it all, God, in your son's name. God, let the Holy Ghost fall upon this place. God, open up the windows of heaven and pour out your spirit upon this place. God, we ask it, Lord. God, in your son's precious name. And the church will say amen and amen. Amen.
Page 19. It's an old time hymn, Come and Dine. We're going to go right into our praise song that we do over service. This is the day that the Lord has made. After we do this, we'll go into that song. Jesus has a table spread.
Jesus, all the time.
Anybody have a prayer request?
Continue to remember Virginia and Joshua that will do the will of the Lord. In a situation that we can go to pray for God.
Pray for my friend because she's having surgery tomorrow.
Amen.
Anybody else?
Remember me and my family prayer tonight. Remember an old friend of mine. Requested prayer for him at church last night. And he ended up in the hospital last night, actually. But God knows what he's doing, so just remember him. His name is Kevin. He's homeless, I think. Going through a really rough time, so he's been on my heart. So y'all remember him in prayer.
Anybody else?
Let's remember Sister Janet and Kelly and Stephanie.
Remember Kaylee, she has surgery today. And remember Colton, he's improving each day.
Amen.
I want to keep my Nana in prayer because she had died a long time ago because she had a hard time. And I tried when I've been spending nights with her. Sometimes I've been trying to take care of her and her, and she got her look like she kind of passed up in the middle of the night. And I want to keep her in prayer.
Anybody else?
Please remember my daughter Megan. She has scoliosis. And from the time we found out about it to the time she had to see the surgeon, we had had positive results as far as her spine getting better. But then he wanted to do a 3-month checkup. So 3 months later, which was a couple weeks ago, we went back. And her results this time were bad. And he went from saying last time, he was like, well, if she was my daughter, I wouldn't operate. And this time he said, if she was my daughter, I would definitely operate because her spine's gotten so much worse than what it was. It just took a turn for the worst. And I asked everybody to please remember her because that surgery could leave her paralyzed.
That's
it,
right.
Could take her life. It could, you know, but I got to think of the positive and know that God's going to take their care of her and see her through, and that she's going to come out better off than she was when she went in.
Anybody else?
Remember me on prayer for the surgery in the morning, and also pray for Tanya and them because she's hurt pretty badly and live.
Remember me and my family tonight.
Pray for my sister Kathy. Mama, she's been having blood pressure about up and down, but let's just keep her in prayer. Let her blood pressure be normal. And pray for Daddy Don, because he's been up and down on his blood pressure too, so keep her in
Anybody else?
I want y'all to remember Mom and Daddy. They're going through a lot right now, and they just need God to move in some situations. And just, my dad needs a lot more strength than what he's got.
Pray for Becky Chaffin as prepared on live stream for her adopted mom, Carla, and also Lori Webb. Ask for prayer for Anthony and the family to have mercies traveling because they're coming back home.
Anybody else?
Remember the service tonight that everybody had
on the Amen. Also, I'd like for y'all to remember my lost loved one that I got from lost loved one. Needs to be saved. Remember Rita Walden tonight. She has to go back. I think she went back today. She went back to Lexington today. I haven't heard nothing from them. So let's remember them. Remember the direction of the church, that God will just keep blessing and moving in it. So remember our young people tonight, that God will just bless them if they just let go and let God bless them. And let's remember. remember if there be someone here that's lost tonight, that they find Jesus.
Yes. Anybody else?
Also remember Nora, she's got to go back to Louisville Tuesday for her 11th treatment. So one more and it's all done, so y'all just pray for her. I remember Gordy Roster too. She lost her daddy and she's at the funeral home right now. And she, our assistant pastor name's there with her. She's having a rough time. They babysit for them. And so they're there tonight being with her. So y'all remember her tonight.
Any other prayer requests? I love lifting them in your hand. Pray to see you. I'm very thankful.
Oh, blessed Lord God, as we come to you tonight, God, we thank you, Lord God, for another opportunity. God, another opportunity to be in your house. God, another opportunity to lift you up. God, another opportunity to give you praise tonight. God, we just ask God to remember these requests, God. God, you heard each and every one, God, that was mentioned tonight, God, and I pray, God, that you would move upon the Lord. I pray, God, that you would save the lost, Lord God. I pray that you would remember our families tonight, God. Heavenly Father, God, we ask, God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, that you would just have your way tonight, God. I pray that you would really unspoken requests, Lord. God, you see the hands that we have tonight, God. Oh, Lord God, we just pray, God, for our man to come to you, Lord God. I would pray, God, that you would, Lord, move upon our brethren, Lord, and remind us, Lord, that you, God, are sitting in our bedrooms and our tongues, Lord God. House arrests and brothers, God, I pray, God. Most of all, God, you saved our souls, God. And Heavenly Father, God, I ask, God, that you would, Lord, bless Brother Wayne tonight, God, what journeys he brings to the bread of life for tonight, God. I pray, God, that you would anoint him with a special anointing. I pray, God, that you would just move in a mighty way, God. I pray that you would help our young people tonight, God. You bless them. God, those that's mentioned tonight, God, you bless them too, Lord God. Heavenly Father, God, we ask you right now, God. I pray for the peace in Jerusalem, dear God, tonight, God. But Lord God, we pray for Israel tonight, Lord. I pray, God, that you would keep your hand, God, hold our military, not just responders, Lord God. Heavenly Father, God, I ask you right now, God. Lord God, those, God, that's out there helping lives, God, being on the floods, Lord God. I pray that you keep your hands up, oh God. Lord God, we ask in the name of Jesus, God, our soldiers, Lord, that fight for our country, Lord God, and for our freedom. I pray, God, to put your hand on our chest upon them. Oh, God, I pray, God, that you open the windows of heaven tonight, God, and pour out your spirit upon this place. But Lord God, open the ears that they can hear what the Spirit would say unto the church tonight, God. Heavenly Father, God, I ask, God, in the name of Jesus, God. God, we give you all the praise. God, we give you all the glory. God, you're worthy to be praised. God, we thank you, God. Lord God, we praise you, God, in Jesus Christ, your holy name. Thank you. This offering tonight is going to go for the youth. The church is going to take care of the preacher tonight, but this offering goes to help the youth tonight.
Thank you. Oh,
Can I say something real quick? Alright, what's going to be while I was singing was, y'all want a Holy Ghost tear down service? Then stand up. Start praising the Lord with your praise. Don't sit there and say hallelujah. Actually stand up and mean it. You know, last time we had children's church, we had a tear down because people was putting in. Y'all want something, y'all need to put in.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. I'm proud of our young people tonight. Amen. Amen.
me on to good home. Jesus speaks in ease.
sign upon this altar. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
God, Jesus. Jesus. This is y'all's service. This is the young people's service. No matter what church you belong to, if you feel like you need to pray, you need to come. Come while the water's troubled. Brother Red ain't going to worry about that. Glory to God, this is what it's all about, is seeing young people pray. See them seeking God, glory to God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God, glory to God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Take
the
control.
Glory, glory, glory.
Hallelujah.
three still praying. Glory to God, but that's not going to hinder the word still going out tonight. Glory to God. Let's give Jesus a great big hand tonight. Let me give him a big hand tonight. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Let's give our preacher tonight, Brother Jeremy Ferreira, a big hand. Hallelujah. Good to be here in the house of the Lord tonight. I believe if some of us would have minded God, we wouldn't even have had any preaching tonight.
Amen.
Amen. But if God will help us tonight, amen, I've come to share with you all that the Lord has put on my heart tonight. Thank the Lord for everybody that came out to be with us. Good to see my pastor and all the people from over at our church. It's good to be here with family and old friends. Brother David Miller gave me the opportunity to go with him. Well, I think I was about 18 years old. We went up to Detroit, Michigan, and was I 17? Yeah, I believe I was. And we went up to Detroit, Michigan, and man, I tell you, if you can preach up there, you can preach anywhere. Amen. So got up there and didn't know what to expect. Small town boy from Glasgow, Kentucky, and. Got up there, man, we got ready to go into the church and had to unlock bars. It was just like going into a jailhouse, amen. But we went up there and did all that the Lord would allow us to do, amen. And just had a good time in the Lord. And I've known Brother David for years, Brother Don, and he's always encouraged me in the Lord. I want to thank you tonight for giving me this opportunity to come out and preach in this service tonight, amen. So, if you have your Bibles, turn with me tonight in the book of Job in chapter number 23. Amen, church. I'll make you a solemn promise tonight, amen, that if you'll get in through the preaching of God's word with me, amen. I've worked all day long and I'm tired in body, amen. But if you'll get in the word with me and you'll get behind me and help me preach, amen, I'll give 110% tonight, amen, for the glory of God's kingdom, amen. Hallelujah, amen. I'm ready to preach tonight. I said, it seems like when I was sitting there, amen, I felt like a bull in a china shop, amen, just ready to cut loose and let go. But, amen, I was going to wait on the Lord. And I know, amen, if some of us would have minded the Lord, amen, we wouldn't even been having to preach tonight, amen. Hallelujah, amen. The Bible says, where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty. Amen. The Bible also says, amen, that whom the Son sets free, amen, is free indeed. Amen. I'm thankful to God tonight, amen, that in the altar of prayer, amen, October the 21st, 2017, I backslid on the Lord for 10 years. Amen. But I thank the Lord, amen, that he did not withdraw his hand. Amen. I thank the Lord. Job chapter number 23. I believe we'll start tonight, amen, in verse number 3. Oh, that I knew where I might find him, that I might come even to his seat. I would order my cause before him and fill my mouth with arguments. I would know the words which he would answer me and understand what he would say to me.
Hallelujah, amen. How many knows that unless we're in the spirit, amen, we can't receive nothing from God. Amen. Will he plead against me with his great power? No, but would he put strength in me? Hallelujah. Amen. There the righteous might dispute with him, so should I be delivered forever from my judge. Behold, I go forward, but he is not there, and backward, but I cannot perceive him. Oh, I feel like preaching tonight. Hallelujah. Amen. And on the left hand, where he doth work, but I cannot behold him. He hideth himself on the right hand, but I cannot see him. Oh, hallelujah. But he that knoweth the way that I take, hallelujah, when he hath tried me, I shall come forth as gold. My foot hath held his steps. His way have I kept and not declined. Neither have I gone back from the commandment of his lips. I have esteemed the word of his mouth more than my necessary food. Hallelujah. Amen. The T-bone will be nice. Amen. But how many would agree that the Holy Ghost is better? Such things are with him, therefore am I troubled at his presence. Amen. When I consider, I am afraid of him, for God maketh my heart soft, and the Almighty troubleth me. Hallelujah. Because I was not cut off before the darkness, neither had he covered the darkness from my face. Get your hand this way and pray with me tonight, church. Father, we thank you tonight, God, Lord, for the opportunity, God, Lord, to be in your house tonight, God. And Lord, I know, God, Lord, that I'm tired and bothered, God. Lord, but if I could get out of this place, Lord, I got more, God, it's just a few minutes of time. And God, Lord, if you would use your servant tonight, God, Lord, to deliver all the damage put upon my spirit, God. Lord, feed your people tonight, God. Hide us behind the cross, God. And Lord, if there be any glory, God, any honor, any praise, God, Lord, let it be unto you, God. Now, Father, we'll be careful, God. Won't take no credit for nothing, God. Lord, I pray tonight, God. Lord, that you would anoint our ears tonight, God. God, I pray that you empower our hearts, God, that we might receive the word into good ground, and let it bring forth fruit. And God, some 100 and some 60-fold. Chains, and all the church would say amen. Hallelujah. I began my sister Ann yesterday on the way home. I testified at church last night. Amen. You know what? Amen. Who is man that thou art mindful of him? Or the son of man that thou wouldst visit him? Hallelujah. I started home yesterday from work. Amen. Can I tell you that the devil is mad? Job, why don't you curse God and die?
Yeah.
Yes, hallelujah. Sir. Come on now. There's a doubting Thomas. Amen. In every crowd. Amen. Right. Somebody always trying to pull down what God is trying to do. Amen. Job said, amen. You speaking like a foolish woman. You can call it a fool. Amen. Don't say you're speaking like a foolish woman. Amen. The Lord give it up. And the Lord take it away.
Amen.
Spiritually speaking, amen.
Yes,
Hallelujah. But, amen. Job began to see, amen, in the spiritual eye.
Yes,
amen. The Bible said, Job got hungry.
Yeah.
Amen. If you'll get hungry,
yeah.
Jesus said, amen. Bless all they that thirst. And hunger after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Amen. Job, amen, said, I desire the Lord, amen, more than the necessary thing. Sister Kathy, amen, for my soul desires,
yeah.
Amen, the word of God,
yeah.
The word of God, amen, Lord. Hallelujah,
yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Yeah.
Thank
you, Jesus.
Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
But he is in one mind, and who can turn him?
Right.
And what his soul desires, amen, even that he doeth. We can't stop God, can we?
Right.
Amen. For he performeth the thing that is appointed for me. Amen.
Come
I want to tell you tonight, amen, through the Spirit, and while under the anointing tonight, amen, that God, amen, has, amen, a plan for you.
Yeah.
I know the thoughts that I think towards you, still the Lord. Amen. Thoughts of peace. Amen. Amen. You got something appointed for you. I've got something appointed for me. Amen. And God said, amen, look at here, if I be for you, who can be against you? Unto the man that everybody likes. Amen. Because he ain't doing something. Soul desireth, even that he doeth.
Yes.
For he performeth the thing which is appointed, or that is appointed for me.
Come on.
And many such things are with him.
That's
amen.
Right.
For God maketh my heart soft, and the Almighty troubleth me. Amen. Because I was not cut off before the darkness.
Right.
Amen. Can you see the tide beginning to turn here? Amen.
Yeah.
Job was no longer, amen, saying, God, amen, where are you? And we'll get ourselves, Sister Ann,
that's
into
right.
A place, amen, where God can talk to us.
Yeah.
Amen. Put all the doubt, amen, and gloom and doom, rose under me. Amen. And throw a pew party. Amen. But it will, amen, get hardened like a good soul. Everybody wants it good and easy.
Yes.
Good and easy, but I tell you, the Bible says, thou therefore endure hardness as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. Amen. Let them call you a false prophet. Amen. Let them say whatever they want to. Amen. But I'm telling you tonight, amen, Job couldn't stop God. When God said, I'm bringing you out, amen, they couldn't go down. Amen, in hell. Amen, stop the move of God. Amen. If Get yourself in a place. Amen. On sackcloth and ashes. Amen. Amen. And get to the place that you're humble before God. Amen. And say, Lord, here I am. Send me. Amen. I'm telling you, if you get yourself upon your knees, God needs you up. Some fairy tale, amen.
Right.
Amen. But I'm talking about Father God.
Right.
Amen. Yeah. Jesus Christ. Amen. The king's touch. Amen. Everything you touch turn to gold. Amen. I tell you what, it don't matter what's coming against you tonight. Amen. In your life, get to the place where God can talk to you. Amen. Look here, I tell it in our church. And Sister Ann will tell you. Amen. Look here, it ain't on Facebook. Amen. It might be stream live. Amen. But it ain't on Facebook. Amen. It ain't on Snapchat. It ain't on Instagram. Sister Ann, but I don't even worry about it anymore. God said, if you'll stand up, I'll fill your mouth. And when you're going to stand, I don't know how Jesus did. Script. Amen. Ain't got it written down on paper. Amen. Looky here. That ain't how God works. Amen. Looky here. We got some. Amen. Get them away from the platform. Amen. And they don't know what to do. Amen. If they get a hold. Amen. I'll be anointed. Amen. I'll show them. Amen. The Bible says that he will fill their mind. Amen. And tell them what they ought to say, Brother David.
That's right.
But got home, Spirit of the Lord was all over me, picked up my Bible, Lord, where do you want me to go? He opened it up, amen, to Acts chapter number 17, amen, that scripture I wrote off to you a while ago, amen, that Apostle Paul said, amen, if you might just happily feel after him, amen, he's not very far from any of us, amen, he wasn't far from Job, and he wasn't far from me, amen, you know how I know, amen, because I was in a bar room, in Bowling Green, Kentucky, amen, you can believe it, amen, or you don't have to, but I'll tell you right now, amen, Jesus, amen, keep the door in, to the bathroom, amen, I saw, amen, myself in the mirror, and God spoke to me, and so what are you doing here?
Yeah, amen, hallelujah,
bless
him,
yeah. He ain't scared to go in a bar. Amen. You think he's scared to go in there? You think he's too good to go in there? But I'm going to drop a bombshell on you. Amen. When he died on the cross, amen, the Bible says, amen, that he must be 3 days and 3 nights. Can I preach? Can I preach tonight? Amen. It's true. As long as was. Amen. 3 days and nights. In the belly of the whale. Amen. So much the Son of Man. I've got the keys. Amen. To death, hell, and the grave. That's what the Bible says. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Took the keys. Death, hell, and the grave. He ain't too good to go in them places. Amen.
Right.
Hallelujah. Amen. Our question tonight for the church is, amen, not where are you, God? Amen. Not how long, oh Lord? Amen. Not none of these doubt and gloom and doom. Amen. Scenarios that the devil likes to keep you wrapped up in. Amen. In your spirit and your mind. Amen. You believe a lie. Amen. And you want to lie. Amen. The heavens are praising over the top of you. Amen. If you let go and let God. Let go and let God.
Uh-huh.
He'll meet your needs.
Yes,
he will. I believe that. Stand all over the house with us tonight.
Come on.
Hallelujah. Sometimes I preach 30 minutes. Sometimes I preach an hour. Sometimes I lose all track of times, and then it's the best times. I don't wear no watch anyway.
That's right.
I guess I've done preached 10 minutes, ain't I?
Hey, Richard. Hey, this is God's time.
Hallelujah. Job said, I can't find the Lord.
Right.
He said, I looked to my left, he's not there.
Right.
He said, I looked to my right, and God's not there. Hallelujah.
Come on, Brother Red.
He said, the heavens are brazen over the top of my head. Amen. Where is God? Amen. I'm so hungry for the Lord. Amen. Job said, I would desire the hand of the Lord. Amen. Just a little bit of food. Amen. From the Word of God. Amen. The my necessary food. Hallelujah.
Come on.
Church, if you're under this house tonight, under this roof, amen, and it feels like, amen, that God is a million miles away from you. Amen. If for no other reason, amen, God sent me to tell you, amen, tonight that he's not very far from you. Amen. He sees the tears that you're crying. Amen. He knows how many nights, amen, that you tossed and turned. Amen. The devil tried to stop me, amen, from preaching to you tonight. If I could testify, amen, when I got here, amen, I felt a pain in my lower back. Amen. Saw all the way across. Amen. And it hurt. But I was rebuke the devil in the name of Jesus. Amen. Because I know, and I know, amen, that somebody, amen, needed to hear, amen, that God ain't very far. Amen. Just reach after him. Amen. And feel burned. Amen. Because he's there. Amen. He said, I'll go with you all the way, even unto the end.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yes, he did. Yes, he did.
Amen. Hallelujah. We want to open the altar tonight. Amen. If you would like to pray, the altar is open.
That's right.
You got, it's been open all night. Amen.
That's right.
If we'd have just obeyed the Lord, like I said,
that's right.
Amen. We wouldn't even have to have any preaching.
Right.
Amen. But it was God's will, so we're going to go with it. Amen.
Amen.
But this altar is open to you tonight. Amen. If you have need of the Lord, amen, come tonight. Amen. While they sing, come. Amen. And lift your voice. Amen. Unto God. Amen. And say, Lord, here am I. Amen. Use me, Lord.
Come on,
your glory. Hallelujah.
So you look around,
praise the Lord.
See how you can sit on your seat. Hallelujah. I tell the church, this altar is not for the sinners, it's for the church. Hallelujah. The altar is for the church. But the sinners come and give their life to the Lord, but the altar is for the church to get closer to God. Hallelujah. You've heard the word. And now it's obligated to you to live by that. Somebody's heart a while ago, they just keep pushing it off. Hallelujah. Oh, how do you know that, Brother Miller? Because I felt it in my spirit that God was dealing with somebody. And they said,
I'm
His friends even come and sat there with him. But boy, when they came with the doom and gloom, just like the devil comes to the Christians with doom and gloom. Well, this one talking about you, and that one's talking about you. Ain't no need to listen, but Brother Red, you hold your head up.
Amen.
Can I tell you what? I was out here praying Saturday. I walked in the door, and God said, go back out, walk back in. He said, when you come into my courts, you come in with thanksgiving.
Amen.
He said, when you come in here, you begin to start thanking me. He said, and after you get through that thanksgiving, then you get to go into the gates of praise.
Yeah.
And when you begin to walk into the gates of praise, he said, then you can be able to praise me. But while I was getting into the gates of praise, Brother Randy spoke to me. He said, get Jeremy to preach. Get Jeremy to preach. Okay, Lord. I didn't tell nobody. That's Brother Red. I just told him, I said, don't you tell nobody. Until I get it all put on the internet, then you can tell who you want to. And you know what? The devil was mad.
Amen.
You know what? It made him so mad he couldn't see straight. Are you sure you want him to come preach your church? God told me to ask him to come. And I asked my wife, I said, who's coming? She said, Red.
And your daughter done said it too.
Can I tell you something, church? The devil will come to you and tell you everything.
Right.
And he, you know what? He'll knock you off your feet.
Yes.
But you got to pray. You got to seek God. You got to get a hope. That, you know what? After you get through the gates of praise, guess what?
Come on.
Sister Darlene, you have to turn back around.
Yes, you do.
You're in the gates of praise right now.
Come on.
You have to turn back around. And guess what? You got to go towards the brazen altar.
Yeah.
And you got to get a hold of the horns of the altar. And when you get a hold of the horns of the altar, guess what? The devil cannot do nothing to you.
Amen.
You say, Brother Miller, praise is coming in here singing songs to God. No. Wrong. You know what their praise was when the priest went into the tabernacle? Hallelujah. 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 Oh, you say, Brother Miller, are you sure? Yeah, you read the Word of God. The Bible says over in Revelations, glory to God, he said they come and before the throne, glory to God, and they said hallelujah.
That's right.
Hallelujah. They didn't say hallelujah, they said hallelujah. And hallelujah means hallelujah. Glory to God. God said you will praise me.
Come on.
Just like Job, he praised him. Just like Red did tonight, he came ahead anyway when the devil tried to knock his feet out from under him.
Right.
He could have just, well, I'm not going. I'm just going to tell him I'm not coming.
Come on.
Can I tell you something? Come here. Hallelujah. This has been on my heart for a long time. I prayed for this boy for many and many of nights. Many and many of nights. And you know what the devil will say? Why are you praying for him? That ain't going to do you no good. I got him. I got him where I want him. I said, devil, you ain't got him. I said, he's just out there like the prodigal son. He's wandering out. He's filling up his Cheerios. He's out there trying to do what he wanted to do. But I said, guess what? The prodigal son came back home. Young man,
come on.
Nobody didn't know nothing about it. We didn't say nothing to nobody. But before we went to Michigan, I had to take him to the hospital and have his stomach pumped.
Come on.
Yep.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
Yes.
No, they was
going to
pump it.
They gave him that Batman junk.
Yeah.
I didn't say nothing to nobody. We didn't say nothing to nobody. We headed out to Detroit, Michigan. Oh, but we had to go by somebody's house.
Mm-hmm.
Brother Red, we come into that man's house, Brother Hale.
Knocked on his door.
Yes.
Lima, Ohio.
He said, come on in. In Lima, Ohio, he said, come on in. Sister Nora, Sister Hale's in there in the living room. Me and the boys are going to sit right here.
Come on.
He said, now boys, y'all want something to drink? I said, yeah, I'll take a Coke.
Say Coke or Sprite.
I don't
know. It was one of them. He went into the kitchen. Went in there and reached up to the cabinet. And the Holy Ghost hit him. And he came back into the kitchen, back in there where we were sitting at, and he pointed his finger at him.
Come on.
Hallelujah. And I remember this to the day I die. He said, young man, who God's called, he's qualified.
Yes.
And he said that gift that God's gave you, he don't just give it to anybody. But I also remember this. He said the devil is going to try to steal it away.
That's right. Come on. Come on.
And he stuck that little bony finger in his face and he said, young man, those pills that you took, you thought that you didn't see, nobody seen that, but he said the Holy Ghost did.
That's right, come on.
We had said nothing to nobody. Promise, nobody.
Yes.
He had a headache. He went in there to get something for a headache, and he got the wrong stuff.
Yeah.
But he also told him, he said, young man, he said to quote that Bible, word for word and not miss a word.
Amen.
God only gives that to certain ones.
Amen.
He said that is going to come. Just like some people want it. He said only God gives that.
That's right.
And he said the devil wants to take that away from you. And I reminded the devil. I reminded him what Brother Hale said. Every time I pray, I say, God, I want to. Every time I see him, I didn't ask him to come to church. I didn't knock. I didn't push at him. You can ask him. I did not. I didn't try to force nothing on him. I just prayed.
Yes.
And I talked to the king.
Yes.
And guess what? The king said, my son's coming home. He knows. He said, I'm looking for him. Really? Just pick Jesus up right where he left him at. And can I tell you something else? There's another young man that people's putting down, knocking him down, saying there ain't nothing wrong about him. But can I tell you, when God speaks to him and says, I'm going to kill you if you don't start doing what I've called you to do, guess what? You better start doing what God's called you to do.
That's right.
And you know what I told him? I said, Brian Kirby, everybody knows him. I said, let me tell you something. I said, I don't care what the world says about you. I don't care what you got all over your body. I said, once it's under the blood, it's under the blood.
Right.
I said, they're not going back and do it again.
Right.
I said, when God takes and washes it away, it's gone.
That's right.
I said, let the world's going to bring it back up to all. You can make all kinds of money. You can do this. The devil told Red, oh, just go ahead. I'll show you a living.
Right.
I'll show you what to do.
Right.
But I prayed, and God spoke to me and said, ask Red. Ask Red.
Yes.
And as he said, we went to Detroit, Michigan. Never seen a boy so scared in my life.
I didn't even want to leave the porch. We was right in the ghetto. We wasn't in the suburbs. We wasn't in the middle class neighborhoods. We was in the ghetto.
Yeah.
They wasn't trying to hide nothing, Brother Don. They was selling crack right in front of the house.
Right.
Most of the houses up there looked like a bomb went off. Yeah. And nobody even cared, yeah. Sister Ann, to clean anything up.
Yeah, that's right.
You don't even wave at people up there because they think you're throwing up gang signs. I believe I'm sitting on my hands on the way to church.
We got there one night, and the Lord spoke to me and said, leave the back doors open. He said, are you sure? I said, yes, the Lord said, leave the back doors open. The pastor said, Brother Miller, we can't do that. I said, well, God told me to tell you to leave them back doors open. And I was preaching on the prodigal son. And there was this big old black guy. I'm talking huge. Red sitting in purple. And he was standing at the back of the door. And you can ask Red, they had little bitty old chairs back there in the floor for the kids to sit in. I'm talking small.
Now, I thought he'd come in to kill us for the record. So.
I'm trying to preach, Red said. I said, I'm preaching. I keep on preaching. I said, be all right. I'll keep on preaching. He comes in the back door. Brother Donnie comes in and he sits down in one of them chairs. He's got a trench coat, black thing on. Red's like, I just kept on preaching. The more I preached, the more I said, Lord, touch Red. The more I preached, I said, Lord, touch Red. Well, the more I prayed for the Lord, touch Red, Red was saying, he's going to kill us. So I said, sit there, kid, and come into the sanctuary. Boy, when he started coming into the sanctuary, come in there and he sat down on the back pew. I'll never forget it. He sat there. And I said, Lord, calm Red down. Just calm him down. They wear them guns and them trench coats. They got them all over. I said, it'll be okay. We're okay. Kept on preaching. When I get the altar call, he got up, started walking up towards the front. Lord, touch Red's nerves, Lord. He was a nervous boy anyway.
I'm just 17.
So, he comes up there. He said, can y'all pray for my mama? Drunker than a monkey. I'm talking alcohol would knock you down. Big old black guy. I'm talking huge. Big alcoholic. Come up there. We begin to pray for his mama. The doctors had told her that she wasn't going to live, that there wasn't no hope. And we prayed for her, his mama. And then I looked at him. And I said, brother, can we all pray for you? Me and Nora and Brother Red began to pray for that young man. And they had seats like you sit in a movie theater that folds up. They when you sit down in them, they go down with you. When you get up, they jump right back up with you. Well, this chair didn't go up. We prayed for that man, Sister Kathy, and the power of God knocked him off his feet. And he fell. Just looked like a big old tree falling. And I ain't kidding you, his head was underneath that seat. And how it got under there, I don't have a clue. But all I know is when he got up, there was not a smell of alcohol on him. There was not one smell. He was sober and in his right mind. And he looked at me. He said, why is he scaring me? And he said, I said, brother, I said, did you come back to God? He said, yes, I did. He said, I was that child that you was talking about. I was that prodigal son. And I told him, I said, brother, I said, we ain't going to take and give you no money, but I said, I'll tell you what we're going to do. I said, we're going to go and buy you some White Castles. We're going to get you some 2 liters, and we're going to get you a bus ticket, and we're going to send you to the hospital where your mama's at. He said, I said, is that all right, Pastor? She said, sure. And we took up the money. We got the money for his bus ticket. We bought him 24 White Castles, 3 large fries, 3 large Cokes, and bought him a bunch of 2 liters to take with him. Didn't give him no money. And Red said, you reckon we'll see him again? I said, probably. Not before the revival ended. Here coming, he came back, sober. And he said, Brother Miller, can I tell y'all something? He said, when I got to where my mama was at, said she was sitting up in the bed, and said she got to go home with me the next day. He said, my mama was alive. So the doctors didn't know what to say about it. I said, because the prophet's son came home. And Red, I took him under my wings.
And he didn't want to go back anymore.
No, he didn't want to go back. But I tell you, God's the one told me to get him to preach tonight.
Amen.
And when God tells me something, I obey him.
Amen.
I do it. Amen. Hallelujah. I thank God for Sister Ann coming tonight.
I don't like to go to too many places, but when God says go, I go, you know. And he said, come here tonight. And it's all because, church, we've got to pull together. And we've got to realize there's only one body.
Amen.
You know, there's many members, many churches, but there's only one body.
Amen.
And we've got to get past all this other stuff. That's if we're right. going to help these young people, if we're going to help one another,
right.
Be able to call upon our brothers
right.
and our sisters
that's
for
right.
prayer. But
that's right.
I just praise God. I praise God for Brother Red. You know, I told him when he started coming over to the church, I said, Brother Red, I said, whether you stay or whether you go, I said, Brother, I said, we'll be the church, not just me, but the church will get behind you and support you and pray for you. Because see, when God's trying to raise somebody back up,
that's
the
right.
enemy's going to be there
that's
really
right.
strong to try to tear them back down. And
that's right.
You know, that's where I say we need one another to continue to do what God's
yes,
called
amen.
Us to do.
Yes.
And Brother Red, you let them keep on talking, brother.
That's right.
You let them keep
amen.
On calling you a false prophet. You know, the word says there's wolves out there in sheep clothing.
That's right.
That's right.
So
come
you got to watch out for them
that's
wolves
right.
in sheep clothing, because they're just out there to hinder and to stop what God's doing. But
right.
I feel good in my spirit about what God's getting ready to do, not just in this church, the body of Christ. I'm getting
yes.
excited
yes.
about what he's going to do in the body of Christ. So
amen.
We just need to pray for one another and encourage one another along the way, and pray for those prodigal sons out
amen.
There.
That's right.
Amen. That's all I'm saying. I said, Wednesday night, we don't have church, go fellowship with somebody else.
Right. Yes.
I said, because if you're going to make it to heaven, you got to love one another.
Right.
You can't talk about another
yeah.
pastor. You can't put another pastor down. You got to pray for them. If they're doing wrong, you pray for them. You don't put them down, you just pray for them.
Yeah, come on.
And let God take care of that. But the Bible said that we're supposed to fellowship one with another.
Right.
Hallelujah. If you can't fellowship here, how do you think you're going to go to heaven together?
Amen.
Amen.
That's the Bible. That's not me. The Bible said if you can't love your brother and sister who you have seen, how can you love him who you haven't seen?
That's right.
We got a prayer box. We got a prayer box up here. And if any of y'all, visitors, has got a prayer request that you want to write on a piece of paper and put in our prayer box right here, we pray over it every night. Every service, we pray over our prayer box. People put in lost loved ones. They put people in there that's sick. People that needs to be saved. People that needs a spiritual touch. People that needs a blessing, a financial blessing. Whatever it is, just write it on a piece of paper and drop it down in that box, because we don't open it up. We don't look at it. We just ask God to take care of it. Years ago, churches used to have them in the church. You don't see them no more in the church. You don't hear them praying for people's needs much anymore in the church. You don't hardly ever hear them testify anymore in the church.
Yeah, come on.
I see the church with the suggestion box.
Amen. Can I tell you this? This man right here and his wife back there came back to the Lord. The devil had them out in sin. Had them way out there, but guess what? God went right where they were at, Brother Red, and he pulled them back in. Every serving God. Singing for the Lord. The Bible said make a joyful noise unto the Lord.
Right.
He didn't say how good it had to be, just said joyful.
Amen.
Right?
Right.
That's the word. Hallelujah. Yeah. I'm just waiting for the Holy Ghost to get on him. He sent me a video of this gorilla in a swimming pool shouting. I said, I'm just waiting to see the Holy Ghost get on him. He'd be that gorilla. Amen. I appreciate it. Anybody else want to testify? Brother, you want to say something for the Lord?
No, you don't.
Anybody want to say something?
James?
Caleb?
Excuse me.
You called me out of
here too. Well, I got used to that name.
I just want to praise God for saving my soul. Yes. And tonight I began thanking. I'm like, it really doesn't matter how long the service lasts because it's all in God's time.
That's right.
That's right.
And another
yeah.
thing I think of was I'm not 25% sure, I'm not 75% sure, I'm not 90% sure, I'm absolutely certain if I die tonight, I will go to heaven.
Amen. Hallelujah. Another young person want to testify. Y'all to stand up.
It's waking me up this morning. We are to see my family.
Amen. Hallelujah. Thanks, y'all. Good job.
Let me not fall asleep like I always do.
Amen.
thank him for letting me sing and all that. I want to thank him for letting me come to a foster care that I have a nice sister, a nice brother, and a nice brother, and two foster parents that are nice to me.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Confession's good for the soul.
I just thank God for allowing me to have a wonderful family and being saved.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. That's right. Right. Hey, now, you don't have to come to this church if you want to testify.
Amen.
Young people, y'all can testify. We ain't jealous of nobody.
Elizabeth.
Danielle. Whatever the two girls are back here.
Everybody should have something to be thankful for.
That's right.
Because if he didn't bring me here, Mom, I definitely wouldn't be here right now. I wouldn't know all y'all. And I wouldn't know Tommy and all them and them getting me in the ASL. And these two boys, they have no idea how much it touches me when I see them trying to do it. Even though they don't know how to do all of it, they have no idea how that touches me with it.
Amen. Hallelujah. Somebody else.
Mama, because she's so sick.
Amen.
You want to bet? Daniel, I forgot to say something.
Okay.
Now, I also forgot. I want to thank you for the pastor and she got a big, huge church. And
was born, she weighed 8 pounds and 2 ounces.
Amen. on this. Right afterwards, they took her away not very long and put her in this isolation place. Said something was wrong with her. Had four little tests, and everyone was crazy. But I kept praying, and they kept calling me the praying Nana. They'd go, every time they'd see me, I'd be praying. If I was praying down there in the chapel or praying there, I said, let me go in that little place where she's in there. And the doctor said, you got to ask her mama. And I said, her mama won't care. So I went in there, my daughter-in-law laid hands on her, and she just opened her eyes and looked at me, and I said, she's going to be okay in the name of Jesus. This lady, I called her Miss Doubtin. I had a Miss Positive and a Miss Doubt nurse. I really don't know what Miss Doubt nurse was named, but the other lady's was Angela. And Miss Doubt, she says, well, honey, I believe in Jesus too, said, but you just got to be realistic about this stuff. This baby's going to have some liver failure. That was one of the big things they said. And I said very politely, oh, no, I'm sorry, but you just watch what my God can do.
That's right.
That test is going to come back perfect.
Right.
Well, the first test come in 100% negative. Second test come in as four tests, negative and negative on three. So I had one more test. By the time that test was taking so long to come back, that was that old liver thing. And old Doubty nurse, she even come up to me and said, I believe that that's going to be okay too. And you know it come back 100%.
Amen.
I think I'll free
friends here tonight, man, for blessing me. Yeah.
Amen.
Hey, put your milk right next to you.
Say anything for the Lord before we just that lady right there does.
You mean that?
No,
okay.
This is my first night here, but I really, really enjoyed it. I enjoyed the sermon I've read.
Yes, amen.
It really warmed my heart to see all these kids working together. Y'all keep it up. Let me tell you, there is a God.
Amen.
Back in 2014, I had a major stroke. I couldn't walk. I couldn't talk. They said I'd never walk again. I was in a wheelchair. I was in a hospital in Bowling Green. I told that doctor, I said, my main doctor, he'll show you different.
That's right.
Well, in 3 months, I was out of that wheelchair on a walker. Okay. Yes, Lord. 2 more months, I was home. I was out on the cane. In 2 months, I was off the
train. Amen. Hallelujah.
A year later, they diagnosed me with 3 different types of cancer. Went to the church. Brother Daniel prayed over me. A week later, I went back to the doctor. He said, I don't know what happened, but you ain't got a cancer cell in your body.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 Won't you come? come up here, I want you to lay hands on a prayer box. I want you to pray over a prayer box and anybody else that wants to lay their hands on it. Look, y'all go that way now. Let Brother Ed get in here. And y'all just reach down there and put your hand on that prayer box. We're going to pray over our prayer requests as it's in this box.
God, we pray, God, that you will move upon each and every one. God, you know each and every need that's in this box, Lord. God, you see the needs, Lord. God, you see the lost loved ones. God, you see the sicknesses, Lord. God, you see those that's got cancer, Lord. God, you see those, God, lost. God, you see the lost loved ones, Lord. God, that's in here, God. Lord, God, you see the ones that need your spiritual touch, those that need your financial blessing, Lord. Heavenly Father, God, we ask, God, that you will touch those needs, God. Lord, you said you sent your word, and your word healed me. God, we're sending the word right now. God, right now, in the name of Jesus, God, we thank you for it, God. God, we praise you for it, God, in your son's precious name. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Before we dismiss, anybody want to say something?
I just want to thank the Lord for being here tonight and for him saving my soul. And yeah. His word that ran through tonight.
Amen. Yes. Hallelujah.
I remember when he was young, when he was a teenager.
Amen.
Samson Street.
We had some tear downs.
Yeah.
Y'all remember Brother Daniel tomorrow? He's got surgery. What's that? No, I'll be going to bed early. Been getting up at 9 o'clock.
At TJ.
He'll be at TJ. Have his gallbladder surgery. Let's remember him. I'm glad that everybody's come be with us tonight. Tell you, Sister Ann's got revival starting tomorrow night. So you can go and be famous at little...
It's a youth revival tomorrow night.
Who's
youth
that?
Youth revival.
Youth revival? Mm-hmm. Amen, brother.
Mike Stroman. I'm going to be there Saturday and Sunday, but Nathan Stamps will be there.
That's what I was trying to think of, Nathan Stamps. He's a little young boy, but he's a preacher. Amen. No. Well, I'm going to have our youth leaders testify, and then we're going to dismiss.
I want to thank the Lord tonight for saving me and sanctifying me filled with the Holy Ghost, and he recently called me to preach, and I'm just waiting for God to save him to do it. But I want to thank God for the youth. You know, I remember when I was a youth, and I see so much of myself in some of these. And I just pray that me and Misty can be a light and help them, show them the right way and guide them to do what God wants us to do. And we do have more youth. They're just not here at the moment, but God knows where they're at and it's in their hearts. And so I know God's going to continue to bless us and bring more in. Y'all just keep our little youth group in prayer. Amen.
Amen.
Being here tonight, and I'm thankful that I'm saved, sanctified, and filled with the Holy Ghost. I'm thankful to be able to hear my brother preach tonight, and I'm thankful for everybody to come out and help us, and we're thankful for the youth that they participated tonight, and I just ask that y'all help us to continue to pray for them that they'll grow in the Lord.
Amen.
Let my wife testify and tell you what God done for her.
Yeah, I just thank the Lord and praise him for everything he means to me. I know some people know this, but some don't. I went to the slums in September, and I had melanoma surgery in July. A lot of people don't know that. I had biopsy in May. I had surgery in July. The surgery that I had in July left me to where I couldn't raise this arm but like this high, and if I raised it on up, it would fall down. And I went to Labor Day Fest, and it's in Mississippi. A lot of people know it's the Sloan family. And so I went back a couple of weeks after that, and this brother came up to my husband after service, and he said, service was done over. I didn't know him from nobody. He didn't know me, and I didn't know him. And service was done over, and he asked Miller, he said, do you think your wife would care if I prayed for her? And I went down there. I was on a cane, and I couldn't raise my arm. And he, after service, he asked Miller if he thought I would care for him, praying for me, and he told him. He said, no, she won't care. So I went up over there, and he prayed for me for about 10 things. Now, I didn't know this man from nobody. And he's from Tennessee, and I'm from Kentucky, and we're in Mississippi in a church after the service. And he named off about 10 things, and each individual thing he named off, as he would name off that thing, he would pray for that thing. And he would name off something else, and he would pray for that thing. Well, he named off, he said, I see you've got nerve damage in one of your arms. Well, I about flipped. I looked at Miller, and he looked at me, and that's how you know it's God. When they can tell you stuff about yourself, they don't know you from nobody. And that's how you know it's God. And he said, you've got nerve damage in one of your arms, and he prayed for that. My arm's just fine now. For 2 months, Miller had to fix my arm. Because of nerve damage. But God touched my arm down there, and I don't have to walk with a cane no more. He touched my legs, he touched my knees, and I thank the Lord for that. And there was about 10 things that he called out, and God has touched me. And I praise him for touching me, because I know it was God, because when you don't tell nobody that you've got this problem, and he comes off with it. He said, you're also weak in one of your hands. And when I went down there, I had a knot about the size of an egg on my hand. The doctor here said that it was osteoarthritis. He said, one of your hands is weak. And he prayed for my hand. And there's barely, if you look close, there's a little bit of place there. But I mean, I had something almost like a half of an egg. Like you would boil an egg and cut half of it and put the half over my hand. I had a knot about that size on my hand. And God touched my hand. And I can still play the keyboard for his glory.
Yes.
And you know, I've got 2 more treatments to take. They gave me Keytruda treatments. And I asked the Lord whenever. I was actually shocked. When I was diagnosed with melanoma, I was actually shocked. Because I had been praying and I had been fasting. And the doctor here said, you have melanoma. He said, we can do surgery on you here, or we can send you to a melanoma specialist in Louisville. And I said, send me to Louisville. And from that day, I went home, and I went to my bathroom, and I'd done, like in the Book of Kings, like Hezekiah did. I went to the bathroom, and I prayed, and I sought God, and I turned my face to the wall. And I said, Lord, I know I've not done a lot, but Lord, please take into consideration what I have done, and give me 15 more years. I'm leaving God for 15 more years to praise him and to work for him. I went back the other day, and they done some scans, and they told me that they were good. They didn't have the pathology report back, and they told me they were good. And when I went back in 3 weeks, the doctor told me, he said, we didn't have the pathology report back. He said, but you have a few small places in your bowel. And so that was my doc. There's like 2 doctors I see, and he was the second doctor I see. But my main doctor told Miller in the hall, he said, tell her not to worry about that. And I'm not going to worry about that. And the doctor told Miller, he said, I don't think it's cancer. He said, but we're going to rescan her in 6 weeks. And the main doctor, Dr. Miller, out while he was waiting in the hall, he told my Miller, he said, tell her not to worry about that. And I'm not going to worry about that, because I gave it to God a long time ago. You see, the reason I let it go as long as I did is because I gave it to God. When that place came up on me, I gave it to God. And I prayed and I prayed and I prayed that God would take it away. He didn't take it away that way. He took it away by surgery through a doctor. But that's how he took it away. But these places that they said I had in my bowel, they call it in your sack. I've been praising God for touching my bowel and for touching my sack, for touching my whole digestive tract. And I'm trusting God for a good report because He's my healer and He's the one that makes me live every day. And if He can tell a man in Tennessee that I've got nerve damage in my arm, if He can tell him I've got a weak hand, He can take care of me. And I praise God for that because I know God is the healer. The doctor might help you, but God gets all the glory.
Don't she look good? She's lost some weight. I've lost 37 pounds. I feel better. I've lost 37 pounds since July. I told her I want to get down to 150. She said, no, I don't want you down to that. So I said, well, I'm going to get down to 175. Brother Morris, I feel good. I do. I got to put on some 36 pants tonight. That really made me feel good. Amen. I'm going to ask my son-in-law back there to dismiss us. He's our media guy. He's the one that puts our videos on the internet, on YouTube. Got our church channel all set up. And Michael back there, he's our porter. He's our security. He takes care of the things. Daniel is our bathroom monitor. He watches the kids that goes to the bathroom and plays in the water and the soap and all that. He's also assistant media guy.
Along with Michael.
Along with Michael. Adam is our
fireman.
If somebody ever happens and have to have CPR, we got that covered. He knows all about it. He's fixing to go to chaplain class to be chaplain for the fire department. I tell you, God's really been blessing. But I want to tell each and every one of y'all, if we want to go to heaven, what are we supposed to do?
Love one another.
And fellowship with one another. You know, the day that we're living in right now, we're not in. We're in the last days. We're in perilous times. It's fixing to start happening. That song that she sings, "Perilous Times Is Sure to Come." We're in them perilous times. Seen on the news today where Russia bragging about their nuclear weapons that they got, missiles. You say, Brother Miller, what are we getting ready to do? Well, read the Bible. The Bible says that in the Bible, there in the last, close to the last chapter in the Old Testament, it says that they'll be standing up on their feet, Brother Red, and their eyes will fall out of their eye sockets, and their tongue will consume in their mouth. And they'll fall dead. But He didn't leave us out. He said that God's people was going to walk over top of them. So if you're serving God and you're God's chosen one, guess what? That's not going to bother you because God's going to protect you. He said, I'll protect my own. He'll keep His hand upon me. Hallelujah. Brother Morris right there, he needs a touch from the Lord too. God's still been working on him. Sister Darlene, don't think I didn't know about that. Sister Ann needs touch on her leg. Once you have leg surgery, it's not 100% sure that you're going to be able to do what you want to do. Bend your leg. That's like Sister Emmy. They wanted to do back surgery on me. I got scoliosis real bad. I had it. They wanted to do surgery on me. They wanted to take half of my backbone out and put a steel rod in my back. And they told me that, I said, well, what kind of percentage you going to give me that I can walk? He said, well, I have 100%. I'll give you 10% that you'll walk. I said, well, guess what? As long as my wife can push me in a wheelchair, I'll just be pushed in a wheelchair if it comes time for that. I said, but I'm going to trust in God.
Amen.
And you know what? Back then, they didn't have the hub arounds when they done that, Brother Mike. But now they got them hub arounds. So she wouldn't have to push me in a wheelchair if I had to. But God touched it. And God can take care of that before that surgery. God can straighten it out. But can I tell you this? It's like that sister said, if you got some doubting Thomas doubting it, you need to get that doubting Thomas out. Jesus came and he put the unbelievers out. And when he put them out, then the damsel rose and she was alive. Amen. Brother Josh, go ahead and dismiss us.
Thank you, Lord, for the service, Lord. Thank you for the service you've given us, Lord. Thank you for everybody's here, Lord. I pray, Lord, that you protect them, Lord, on the way home tonight, Lord. I pray that they have a great service at Ann's Church tomorrow, Lord, through the youth revival, Lord. Bring in many souls for the kingdom, Lord. And I pray, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Consider yourself dismissed.